Gaffney police say a man stopped for drunk driving ended up stealing the arresting officer's car and causing a chase that ended with a bad wreck. News 4's Mike McCormick picks up the story live from Spartanburg. And Mike, those involved are still in the hospital?
Yeah, that's right, Nigel. The suspect is in fair condition here at Spartanburg Regional Medical Center, and so is the 62-year-old woman he is accused of hitting. We're told she is badly bruised and has a broken foot.
Gaffney police say an officer stopped 36-year-old Ronnie Martin at a checkpoint here at West Floyd Baker Boulevard and Beltline Road around 2 this morning. Police say they gave Martin a sobriety test and arrested him for DUI, then handcuffed him behind his back and put him in the back of the patrol car. The officers then went to Martin's car. In the meantime, police say Martin managed to put down the back window of the patrol car, open the door, get in the driver's seat and speed away. The officers chased. This is a picture of how it ended. Police say Martin eventually got onto Highway 18 where he crossed the center line and swerved to miss an oncoming car, but ended up losing control, spinning, and hitting the car he tried to miss. Martin was ejected from the police car. Today, that part of Highway 18 was closed so Highway Patrol investigators could reconstruct that accident. It all happened right in front of 10-year-old Saxon Owens' house.
It was kind of scary, but it was weird because I never, like, dreamed or seen that happen to a wreck happen right in front of our house.
And again, the suspect in this case, Ronnie Martin, remains here at Spartanburg Regional Medical Center. We're told he faces a list of charges, and police say he had a stolen gun and drugs on him during that ordeal this morning. And just a few minutes ago, we found out that Gaffney's city administrator has appointed a committee to investigate this whole incident to see if any equipment, policies, or procedures need to be changed to make sure it doesn't happen again. Mike McCormick, WYFF News 4, live tonight in Spartanburg.